One is I can see the knowledge, you have the knowledge, and secondly, you know, you make sure that the client does get interested. You know, it's not like talk and leave, by which the client is also kind of eager to get into it. For the clients who are smart, I think it is very helpful because they feel that, yeah, they should not lose out on something. That's what I see as a strength. You try to do a genuine linkage with the client to help them. Confidence, you know, when you talk to me, first time when I met you, I had the confidence that, yeah, this guy knows something. Keep on going saying that this is how it will help you, and then it works out. Because at that point, if you drop it, then I'm also going to drop it. But there are cases when, you know, where I may know for sure that I don't want to go into it right now. Then whatever you know, I'm not going to sign up. But there are cases where, you know, where the client is hesitating. That is where, you know, you do a good job. I have always liked you as a person. In the beginning, day one, and maybe, I think there's one thing I should tell you. Like you say, can you take out your mobile phone and start from A to Z? Because then, you know, some people may have more in that list. Young person, energy. And you came into UBS, so I thought anybody who can enter UBS means it should be. I think what I liked was the nature of the product. The kind of product you were proposing, it suited my needs. Basically, fitting my needs at that time. Honestly, I'm more focused into this training kind of activity. Because, you know, we don't look at where the outflow is, and we don't know how to get the inflow. The outflow is happening all the time. In magazines, what you said in the newsletter, it's also good. I do read it sometimes. Not all the articles, but at least, you know, it makes me remember that, yeah, spelling out more about what kind of financial products you have, right? For example, an innate prospect may not know what all you sell. I mean, if you put that in your newsletter or website or somewhere, as I get older, that when you are, you know, in the young age, then you have a lot of potential to invest. Then after, as you get older, then the focus comes on more on the retirement, post-retirement, and how to carry on your life. Maybe you want to make it spiritual or as a service. That kind of thoughts come in.